Hey, today I'm talking about Sonic the Hedgehog 2. This movie is pretty great. I was very pleasantly surprised by the first movie. I enjoyed it quite a bit. I went in with pretty low expectations and was definitely pleasantly surprised by it. This one, I would say, definitely improves upon that film. They definitely, without a doubt, do a lot of things right here. I'm not like a huge Sonic fan. I did play a few of the games way back in the day, but I don't like super hardcore know the lore. But from what I gathered, they really did do a good job respecting the lore in this movie, which I really, really liked. I also loved the inclusion of Tails. Tails was one of my favorite characters playing the Sonic games, so it was just, I love them. And I especially love that they actually got the original voice actor back. That's so cool. I love it when they do that. I wasn't a big fan of Idris Elba as Knuckles, just because he just kind of sounds just like Idris Elba, and he's not really doing a different voice. And it was extra weird because, like, Knuckles is supposed to be the same age as Sonic, and though the two actors are only 10 years apart, Ben Schwartz does a good job of sounding like a teenage cartoon character, but Idris Elba just sounds like a 50-year-old black man, and I'm like, nah. I mean, he did fine. His performance didn't really add anything to the movie for me, though it also didn't really take away anything. It was fine. It was okay. It worked. I just would have preferred something different. I also really loved that, for the most part, they kind of let the humans take a backseat and let all the animated creatures out of the foreground, which just makes so much sense, because the movie's called Sonic. It's not called Small Town Sheriff Does Silly Things. So, like, James Marsden goes off to Hawaii, and then Sonic and Tails go on a legit adventure, and I'm like, I'm loving every second of this. This is great. James Marsden's kind of more there as just like kind of the emotional backbone of it all to help kind of frame everything, which I think works really, really well. I always love seeing James Marsden. He's terrific. He has such piercing blue eyes. And Jim Carrey was great. He's ridiculous and over the top, and he was just a lot of fun. My big complaint, though, is the movie felt too long, and it definitely stemmed from giving all of the minor characters a story for them. Like, I legit really, really did not like the wedding story. Like, what was all that about? We easily could have taken all of that out and the movie would have flowed so much better and worked so much better. It seems like it was something from a completely different movie. So that was just weird that was even in this. But even with that, I still like this movie a lot. I ended up putting this at number 12 in the quite like section. And that brings the total out of all the new movies I've seen so far this year up to 17. So it does kind of feel low in my rankings because it's 12 to 17, but most of the new movies I've seen this year, I've enjoyed a lot. So that's why it seems pretty low. It's still good. I still would definitely recommend it if you were a fan of the first one. If you're a fan of Sonic and you didn't see the first one, you could probably just jump into this one and still be fine. Well, it does seem a little silly, but you do you.